Hey, what's up, YouTube? And I am back today with a new video, and I am going to analyze a page that hasn't been built yet. So that's kind of exciting because I don't usually do this, so this is kind of new. So what's unique about this page is it's built entirely on Notion.so, which, as a lot of you know, it's one of the favorite tools that no-code developers use to build and launch products. But it's also a tool that allows you to do a million other things. But I don't work for them, so I will not sell you that product. I just think it's a cool product. So what we're analyzing today is the SAS manual. And the SAS manual is this unlaunched project that will teach you how to build software as a service. So I'm going to tell you immediately what I like about this page, and then I'll tell you what I don't like about this page. And then if you like this video, subscribe. If you don't like this video, let me know in the comments. If you kind of like this video and you like this new style, press the like on the video as a like button or whatever that like thumbs up, right? It's called a thumbs up in YouTube. All right, so let's get started. So what I like about this page, so the fact that it's built on Notion, it's definitely a good thing because it allows you to iterate really quickly. There's a lot of text. And there are different paragraphs here that are quite interesting to read. And I will tell you why. So the first thing you see is, what is this product about? So it will tell you how the person who's building this product, he will teach you how to build software as a service from scratch. Then he will give you a little bit of information about himself. And then it will tell you about how he's going to make this possible. And then he's going to ask you for the email address. And then he will give you a table of content of all the chapters that he will be covering. And it's quite a lot. If you actually look here, there's a lot of value that is being provided. Now, this is all good stuff, but here are the things that I don't understand from reading this page, right? Like really quickly. How much is this going to cost? Why don't you tell me this at the start or somewhere here before, or rather after you're telling me about the content? Why don't you tell me more about this? Why do you wait until the FAQ to tell me about the cost? A lot of people will not read all this far, so you should probably introduce some of these things really early on in the first or second paragraph of your text. Another thing that I'm not too sure about is I understand that you've been working on products for a long time, but why don't you show me some other open source products that you've built and that you could showcase, linking them from GitHub, and I can take a look at those products and then feel more confident that you are indeed the one teacher that I want to follow. And another thing, why did you not include a video that introduces what you're going to do immediately here on the page? As you know, videos are super engaging, and on top of that, they will give you a lot of more like social proof because people see your face, they relate, and you can talk to them about how you're going to do this. And probably in a minute, you can convey way more information that you can do in this whole page. So think about having a video here that where you talk briefly in a minute or 2 minutes about where you're setting yourself up to, and for us to understand what you're going to do. So those are the things that I would initially say about your page. Another thing I'm not too sure about is all this white space at the bottom. It's kind of a joke, I get it. But you know, it's definitely not needed, especially when you're asking for feedback. This is extra stuff that you don't want to add, right? Like it's extra question marks, makes you feel a little bit less serious, which maybe it's all about, you know, being a bit jokery or whatever the word is, being funny about it. But instead, you should consider building a community around this. So if you're sure that this is what you want to build, why don't you introduce the concept of community baked inside this project? And that's kind of like a big feedback piece that I have for you. It's like, consider when you're building your landing page to talk about the anxieties that people are trying to run away from when they're building products. And that's like how to find customers, how to get feedback, how to build technology that scales, which obviously you probably spoke about here if I go further in into the text of this page. But these other things that are also anxiety makers, right? You should talk about that. So community, the marketing stuff. So maybe you're building a community and you're going to have some marketing people in there that are going to help out on those different aspects of building a SaaS. And Yeah, I think that's all I have for you today. Other than that, I think it's a good initial draft of a page. There's definitely some English here that you need to review, and a lot of like lacking, rather, a lot of social proof. So try to think about that video. Try to get some quotes from friends that say, hey, working with this person has been amazing. He's so knowledgeable, et cetera, et cetera. That's going to definitely help you get more or start getting signups. Yeah, that's all I have for you. I hope you've enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next video. Remember to subscribe if you can, and if you cannot, well, I'm sorry, it's free, so just try, right? All right, thank you.